Let's see what is a pushdown automata acceptance. So actually there are two different ways to define the pushdown automata acceptability. When you can see that the pushdown automata is acceptable by using these two different ways. Let's see what is these two different ways. So one is a final state acceptability. Final state acceptability. Whenever we reach the end of the string, okay, then we can say it is a final state acceptability. Let's take AAB is a string. Okay, so here the pushdown automata accepts a string, means it accepts this string when after reading the entire string, whenever it reads the entire string AAB, then the PDA is in final state. From the starting state, we can make moves that end up in a final state with any stack value. So this, the stack values may be anything, but the starting state and should it has to end up with the final state. The stack values are irrelevant. So there is no relevant in the stack values. The thing here is we have to finally reach the final state. As long as we end up in a final state. So let's see what is this, how we can say that the final state, the pushdown automata is a final state acceptance. For a pushdown automata, there are 7 tuples, we know that. Pushdown automata consisting of Q, Sigma, S, Delta, Q naught, I, F. Whereas Q is a set of states and the sigma is the input symbols, S is the stack symbol and delta is a transition function and the Q naught is the initial state, I is the top of the stack and F is the final state. So here that this PDA, the language accepted by set of final state F can be represented as, this is the language PDA can be accepted as W. There is a strings W, whatever the string that you want to accept. Let us take AAB, whatever we have taken. The W such that the Q naught, that is the initial state, W. This is nothing but ID. Did you remember this? The representation ID consisting of triples that we seen in the previous video. Okay. So the terminologies that we used in the pushdown automata is, one is the ID, instantaneous description. Okay, so instantaneous description, Q naught, that is the initial state, W is the unconsumed data and I is the top of the stack element, where the, suppose if it is an empty, you can represent it as empty. And this is a turnstile notation. Okay, so the turnstile notation is connecting the two IDs, two or more IDs. Okay, and here the Q naught is changing its states to Q, means one turnstile move has done. Okay, if it is star is, it can move, the moves may be more than one. And W is changes to the empty state, which reaches the final state. Whenever the stack is empty, okay, it is an epsilon and X is the reaching the final state. Then Q belongs to the final state. So whatever the Q here, that should be belongs to the final state. Then we can say that the string is accepted by the, that is the final acceptability. Okay, for the input string S, X. So here, this X is the input string. So in for that input string, if it reaches the B, the final B, okay, then this Q is becomes the final acceptable state. And another way of representing the pushdown acceptability is empty stack apps acceptability. Either it should be final state or it should be empty stack acceptability. What is this empty stack acceptability? Here, a pushdown automata accepts a string when after reading the entire string, the pushdown automata has emptied its stack. Means finally the stack has to be emptied. Let's see that. For a pushdown automata, that is a 7 tuples Q, Sigma, S, Delta, Q naught, I, F. The language accepted by the empty stack is this. Language accepted by the pushdown automata by using the empty stack. So the same, the W string, whatever that you have to read that string, Q naught, and this is the ID, that is this complete representation is the ID. The first is the state and next is the unconsumed input and is the top of the stack. Okay, turnstile notation, that Q comma epsilon epsilon means it represents the empty stack. Empty stack, and this Q may be any one of the state that is present in the queue. Any one of the state, okay, it should not be, but here the Q should be in final state. But here the queue should be in any one of the state. Okay, it may be at any one of the state, the stack becomes the empty. Then you can say that the stack is that state is an acceptable, empty stack acceptable thing. So these are the two different ways to define the PDA acceptability. One is a final state acceptability and another is empty state, empty stack acceptability. Okay, so in the next video, we'll see the problems on PDA. Thank you.